The year was 1810. The district of Asakusa in Edo was developing into a burgeoning entertainment area, and for one man on his way home from some nearby public baths, was also about to shake his worldview forever. As this young man walked home, he looked up at the night sky and noticed something rapidly getting bigger. It was a man, and he was falling to the ground. But that wasn't the end of the weird sight before him. This young man, who looked to be in his early 20s, was naked, other than the tubby socks on his feet. As he hit the ground in front of the man, apparently unconscious, he stood there frozen on the spot, staring at the baffling sight before him. It wasn't every day that a naked man dropped from the sky in front of you. A few moments later, it finally hit the man what was going on and how much danger this naked stranger was in. He was naked and lying unconscious in the street. He quickly ran to the nearest municipal official to inform him of the strange event that had just occurred. Naturally, the official didn't believe his story that a naked man had fallen from the sky and was now lying unconscious in the street nearby. Even for the Edo period, that was a bit much. Yet the man insisted that his story was true, and the longer the official sat there doing nothing, the more likely it was that this naked man was going to die. After all, he'd just fallen from the sky and hit the ground. It would be a wonder if he was still alive at all. Reluctantly, the official accompanied the man and they went back to the naked stranger. Thankfully, depending on your point of view, the man was still there, unconscious. The official tried waking the man up, calling out to him and shaking him a few times, but this did nothing. Out of options, he pulled the man up and dragged him to the nearest guardhouse. There, he summoned a doctor. After inspecting the man, the doctor informed the official and the young man who found him that the naked stranger had a pulse, so he was still alive. But he appeared to be exhausted. If they let him rest, he would no doubt wake up in his own time. And so he did. And when he woke up, the naked stranger looked at everyone in shock. He wasn't the only one. The official asked him where he was from and why he was naked and lying in the middle of the road. The naked stranger explained that his name was Yasujiro, son of Ito Naizen, and he was from Kyoto. He then asked where he was, looking just as confused as everyone else. The official informed him that they were in Asakusa, Edo, and the man was so shocked that he burst into tears. Then he explained the final moments he remembered before waking up in that very guardhouse. According to Yasujiro, he had been walking with a friend and retainer up Mount Atago to visit a temple there. It was an extremely hot summer's day, so on the way up, the three men sat down and took off their kimonos to cool down for a while. As they were relaxing, an elderly priest came running down the mountain towards them. "Hey, you want to see something interesting? Come with me," he said to the young men, and then ran off again. Intrigued, the three men followed him. And that was the last thing Yasujiro remembered. Next thing he knew, he was lying naked in a guardhouse in Edo, wearing only his tubby socks. Naturally, no one believed his story, and so Yasujiro offered up some proof. "The tubby socks I'm wearing are from Kyoto. Take them to a local maker and show them to him. He will tell you with 100% certainty that they were made in Kyoto." And so the official did as he said and took them to a nearby sock maker. "Where were these made?" he asked the merchant, to which he replied, "Ah, yes, these were made in Kyoto." But there was still something that bothered him. There was no mud on the socks. The man wasn't found wearing any sandals, so on the muddy streets of Asakusa, it didn't add up. If the man really was telling the truth, and his socks seemed to suggest that he was, then that meant he had somehow fallen from the sky in Edo from Kyoto. nothing made sense. Regardless of what anyone believed, the incident still had to be reported to the magistrate's office. Once again, the official asked Yasujiro if he really was telling the truth. Yes, he had been seen literally falling from the sky naked. Yes, there was no mud on his socks that had been made in Kyoto. But it was just too weird. How could a man from the other side of the country fall from the sky? It just wasn't possible. Yasujiro once again stated that he was telling the truth and he could inform the magistrate's office of these exact circumstances. Together, they went over to the office, presumably with some clothes now on, and informed them of what had happened. The officials there once again interrogated Yasujiro, and of course, they found it hard to believe his unbelievable story. Yasujiro insisted he was telling the truth, and never once swayed from his story. Unsure of what to do with him, officials placed him in the Asakusa Dame, a type of prison for the underage and seriously ill, away from the main population of regular criminals. And that, unfortunately, was the last anyone ever heard of Yasujiro, the naked man who fell from the sky. What happened to him after he told the officials his story, or whether he got back to Kyoto, remained a mystery. Only the legend remained, spreading around Edo like wildfire. The elderly priest on Mount Atago undoubtedly had something to do with the strange occurrence, but Yasujiro was unable to remember what happened. And so, the strange event ended as mysteriously as it had begun. But what do you guys think about this one? Let me know in the comments below, and I'll see you again next time.